We know we have to go to the back. You know the ideal moment to take someone's back when they grip your head or when they reach for the head. And there's also another scenario that can happen. You can also go for an arm drag. So an arm drag is basically this. You get someone's elbow, you pull either his back towards you, or I prefer to keep his arm suspended in space and walk around him myself. I believe jiu-jitsu is minimal effort, maximum efficiency. It's always better to block the person and move yourself. It's less work than moving him. Now, when would you do this? So if we're here, right, and controlling from here, and he tries to go with his arm to the inside, see? Well, go back please. So you try to bring your arm to the inside and catch my elbow again. So, yeah. So you just try to make a switch, do it on this side, make the switch, okay? So the moment you go for the switch here, see, the moment you take your arm out, that's when you can go for an elbow grip, pull him sideways, and go for the back. So go on the other side, show here. So he twirls his arm inside, see? Go. No, just go for the inside grip. Go again. This a few times. Okay. So assuming, see, the moment he goes in, go again. Now I'm late. See, now I cannot drag him anymore. But go back, see, the moment he goes, that's when you can quickly drag him and go to his back. So basically, this whole self-defense course could also go in a very basic course of stand-up wrestling, judo even, stand-up grappling, at least the defensive part and attacking when the opportunity presents itself.